FlowiseAI offers support to a lot of different service providers and large language models, and it can get quite difficult to manage all of these different accounts and API keys. But what if I told you you could access all of these models with a single API key, and many of them are completely free? Here's what makes the setup a game changer. You get access to dozens of free models perfect for learning and testing. Say goodbye to managing multiple provider accounts, and switching between the different models could not be any easier. In this video, I'll show you how to combine FlowiseAI with OpenRouter to instantly access hundreds of AI models, from GPT-4 to Claude to open source alternatives, all through a single API key. Before I show you this game-changing solution, let me show you why most FlowiseAI users are making their lives unnecessarily complicated. So on this screen, I've added all the different service providers that are supported by FlowiseAI. And you will notice that for each of these nodes, we have to connect credentials, which means we have to create a new credential and store these in the credential store on FlowiseAI. And of course, in order to create the API keys, you also have to go to the service provider's website, like OpenAI or Anthropic, and create an account, add some credits or billing information, generate your API key, and then finally add it to FlowiseAI. And you kind of have to repeat that step for each and every node that you see on this canvas, and there really are a lot. And of course, you then have to keep track of your credits spent on each of these accounts, and this can very quickly get out of hand. There's a single node in FlowiseAI that most users seem to overlook, yet it's more powerful than all of these other nodes combined. So what we can do is go to chat models, and instead of adding any of these providers, we can instead add the chat OpenAI custom node. And this node does look and feel very different to the normal chat OpenAI node, with one key difference. In this node, we can go to additional parameters and specify a different base path. So that means we will no longer point to the OpenAI servers, but instead we can hook up other providers like OpenRouter. And I will show you how to do that in a minute. You will also notice that we do not have a dropdown to select from the different models, but instead we can select from the over 280 different models available on OpenRouter and simply enter the name of that model in this field. And we can see all the different models that are available on OpenRouter by going to OpenRouter.ai and by clicking on models. Here we can see that there are about 280 models, and this list is growing all the time. So here we could enter something like OpenAI to get access to all the GPT models, or of course, we could enter Claude and get access to all the Claude models as well. And we can also access models like Grok using this service. Now, here's the part that shocked me the most about OpenRouter, and it's something that could save you hundreds of dollars in development cost. As I just showed you, OpenRouter does give you access to all of these flagship models, but what you could also do is go to this prompt pricing slider and simply reduce this down to zero, and this will list all the free models that you can execute without paying a single cent. And this then gives you access to Gemini, the Llama 3.2 models, and much, much more, making this an ideal platform for learning how to build AI applications without having to spend any money. And just to prove to you that this is free, I can go to my account. Let's click on activity, and here you will notice that I executed the Llama 3.2 model, and this cost me nothing. And the same with these Pi3 models. The setup process is surprisingly simple, but there's one critical step that you absolutely must get right. Let's start by creating our OpenRouter account. Go to OpenRouter.ai and click on sign in. Then sign in with your Google account, or click on sign up to create a new account. After signing in, go to your profile and click on keys. Then create a new key, give it a name. I'll just call mine YouTube demo, and let's click on create. Then let's copy this key. Let's go back to FlowiseAI. Then on this chat OpenAI custom node, click on the dropdown, click on create new, give it a name like OpenRouter YouTube demo. It's spaced in at API key, and let's click on add. Now we need to point this node to OpenRouter. So to do that, go to additional parameters, then scroll down to the base path, and we can get the base path by going back to OpenRouter. Let's click on docs, and if we scroll down slightly, we can see the base URL in the sample code. Let's simply copy this URL and let's add it to the base path in FlowWise. We can now close this pop-up, and what we need to do now is specify a model name. And this is super important, especially if you are planning on using free models. When we search for a model like Llama 3.2, we can click on the model name, and by default, this is actually giving us the name of the free model, but something to look out for is you can change this from free to standard, and for the standard model, there is a cost involved in invoking this model. The main difference between the free and the standard model is that the free model, in my experience, does not support tool calling. That might not be true for all the models, so definitely try it yourself, but if you do run into issues related to tool calling, then try switching over to the standard model or use a model like Claude or GPT. To showcase the different use cases, I've created two different demos. This demo simply allows the user to upload a file from their machine and then they can ask any questions about that file. And we are using the OpenRouter connection. Now for this demo, a free model like Llama 3.2 will be ideal. So all we have to do is copy the model name by clicking this button over here or simply copying this string. Then we can add it to FlowWise. Let's save this flow, and in the chat, I'll upload this Apple financial statement. And now we can ask a question like, what was Apple's assets in 2023? And of course, we got our response back. What I'm about to show you will completely change how you think about model selection in FlowWise. If we want to swap out Llama for something like Claude 3 or OpenAI, we no longer have to change this entire node. All we have to do is go to OpenRouter, let's search for GPT-4o, I'm actually going to copy this version of the model, and then swap Llama 3 for GPT-4o. We can now save this, let's clear the chat, I'll upload that file again, let's send that same question again, and now we can see how GPT-4 would respond to the very same question without having to swap out any nodes, change credentials, or anything like that. And yes, OpenRouter also supports tool calling. Here we have an example using GPT-4o on OpenRouter, and we also have a retriever tool that accesses a vector database as well as a calculator tool. So let's ask our tool agent, what was Apple's assets in 2024? We get our response back, and we can see that the retriever tool was indeed called along with the citations. Do take note that not all models support tool calling, and you will receive an error when tool calling is not supported. Now that you've got access to all of these powerful AI models, there's one critical challenge you need to solve. Even the most advanced AI models can sometimes hallucinate or make things up. And when you're building real applications, that's simply not acceptable. In fact, there's a specific pattern that most FlowWise users miss that can eliminate those hallucinations entirely. Click the video on your screen now to learn how to make your AI assistant self-correct and eliminate hallucinations completely. Your users will thank you for building something that they can actually trust.